Guys, welcome to my channel and today's video. Today I'm going to be sharing my experience and overall review on using Moving Beyond the Page, the water cycle unit study. On the page, I've already shared a couple videos on it, but one of the unit studies we just completed was their water cycle. I actually bought the digital version. If you didn't know, Moving Beyond the Page sells physical books that you can buy for your units or digital. Moving Beyond the Page or the water cycle, I decided to buy digital to try it out. I will never buy a digital one again. I like having physical things. Even trying to film this video, I don't know what to do with my hands because I don't have the physical book. So it was a little bit cheaper to buy it online, but honestly, or the digital copy, because you can't print it out. It's not like a PDF printable that you buy online. It's like an online website that you kind of go through. Not my favorite, but we did like the unit. So I just wanted to share all about the water cycle unit. If you're not familiar with Moving Beyond the Page, go check out my overview video. I kind of share a lot of details on it, but how it's broken down is you can buy like a full year of curriculum and they have units that are supposed to go together. So they have their language arts units, and then for every language arts unit, they have a corresponding science or social studies unit. So we were doing Charlotte's Web as our language arts unit, and as you can see, Charlotte's Web is supposed to go with the water cycle. Okay, so I was like, let's give it a shot. Let's do this how they recommend doing it. Well, I'm telling you point blank, to me, there was absolutely no reason these two units needed to go together at all. I like both of the units separately, and to be honest, I wish we would have done them individually because trying to do them both together when they did not feed off of each other just added like longer homeschool days, a little bit more like, oh, we just want to be done with school today, because I kept wanting that connection to happen and it didn't happen. The life cycle science unit would have been a home run with Charlotte's Web. Now that unit was supposed to be done right before this. So see, the life cycle is supposed to be done with the language arts poppy. So if we would have done it first, I feel like, yeah, it would have led into Charlotte's Web really good, but no reason for these two to go together. I haven't done any other two together to see how they correlate, and maybe this one was just a miss, but don't stress yourself out if you don't have extra time. Do them separately and you'll probably enjoy the units much more. So besides that, the water cycle. This unit was really fun. I have a second grader and a fourth grader that are doing it together, and this is meant more for a second grade level, so keep that in mind. We did this over about a 4-week period. We only school 3 days a week, and there's about 7 lessons, but some of them are divided over 2 days. So it took us about a month to get through this water cycle unit. We'll tell you, if we didn't get this unit, I probably would never have known that there was this much information on the water cycle, or even how to really teach it. So I do like it. It was super beneficial. We needed to get a science unit in there. It's been a while since we've done something sciencey in our homeschool. So what I'll do is I'm going to flip through. So the teacher's guide is what is online, and then obviously my kids had some of their printable activities that we did, plus we keep a science notebook, and this is for all of the science units that we do throughout the year. So we've done volcanoes, we've done human body, and so they kind of just add into their science notebook the next thing. So I did get a lot of extra things with this unit on Teacher Pay Teachers, because I just felt like, especially for my fourth grader, we could go a little bit more in depth than how it was going. So I found these cute little doodle note workbooks where they kind of fill in their little doodle notes, they color on the water cycle. And so this is from Teachers Pay Teachers. I think it was free, and so I'll link it down below. It comes with a PowerPoint that you walk through with your kids. So those were really fun. But again, this wasn't necessarily with the unit itself. And then we did end with this water cycle wheel as like kind of our last thing. So all link both of those resources that I got extra down below. Some of the activities, you start the lesson with like, what do you already know about water? And they kind of fill this out with everything that they know about water. There's an activity where for like the week you go outside and you track the different types of clouds. So they learn all about different types of clouds. I also found a really fun activity with cotton balls. I'll link it to where they made the different pictures of clouds. And so that was a really fun activity. And then with the chart, they could go out outside every day, look at all the different clouds. What was cool too is we normally don't get rain where we live, but the week we were doing it, we had the weirdest clouds, the weirdest weather. And so that was really fun for them to see like all the different types of clouds that they could track. With this science unit, there is a book that's recommended, well, required, A Drop Around the World. I did have a hard time finding that book at our local library. And I didn't really want to buy it because you only read it in like one or two of the actual lessons. It's a shorter picture book. So I actually found it on YouTube as a read aloud and we really liked it. Even my four-year-old loved sitting in listening to the book. And so you follow this water drop, we'll call him Drop, through his different stages. And so he goes to different countries and continents and he's in his different states of matter. And so they kind of track and fill that out. They fill out a water cycle wheel. There's different activities that you can do. And so there's a lot of fun, like little hands-on things. We did something super easy with Skittles, just visually seeing like how much water is in the world, how much is salt water, how much is fresh water, how much is accessible to drink. And you start getting more into animals. So there was a whole lesson on fish and like which fish can live in salt water and fresh water and both. And so it recommends getting some books on different types of fish, different animals. So like what animals are in the forest, prairie, Arctic, and like what are the types of water, state of water. So like in the Arctic, it would be ice and snow. In the rainforest, it's raining all the time. There's always precipitation. It's humid. So that is fun where you could branch out and really go into like animal studies and biome studies. And so it really lays like that, just the basic lessons where if you don't want to do anything extra, you don't have to. But if you want to, you can totally add on extras. So it definitely goes through like a wide range of topics. Like I said, I would have never thought about half of the things this taught about the water cycle. To me, the water cycle is like a thing you would teach in one lesson in a science unit. So to have a whole month specifically on the water cycle was really cool. And I think my kids genuinely understand now the water cycle. At the end of every Moving Beyond the Page unit, there's always an end of unit project. And so this one was create a lesson plan and like teach a lesson about the water cycle. So they kind of give your children like, here's the rubric. So make sure that you have, it's like a checklist, right? Like this needs to be included. Planning, like how to plan out your lesson. Like, you know, do you have supplies? Do you have a song? Like what is your hands-on activity going to be? So it really does, like it's gentle and like not just like a free-for-all. It does have review questions on that one book that they were reading. So overall, like I said, I had fun finding extra things on Teachers Pay Teachers. And that's really because I do have an older child doing this and I know she could have handled a lot more information than was in here. So I found those extra resources. You know, we had fun creating like little graphs and stuff on the water cycle. I even found, and I'll link it down below, a little test. Oh, and there was one more thing. We were trying out Generation Genius and they're like science videos and you can get a free trial. And they had one on the water cycle. So one day I just decided to add in like, let's watch the Generation Genius video. So we watched them explain the water cycle and then we did their kind of review questions on it. So then that was fun because those videos are super fun and engaging. What we wanted to do, and I just remembered it as I'm filming this video, is we also wanted to watch Bill Nye. We love Bill Nye, my kids. Bill Nye. My kids, even though the videos are old, they absolutely love them. Same with Magic School Bus. So we'll probably find the Bill Nye and if there's a Magic School Bus episode on the water cycle. That's what we always do in any science lesson. If we can find videos from those two resources, we normally do. So those will be the things. Honestly, the reason I probably forgot is, like I said, I tried to do this at the same time we were doing Charlotte's Web because I thought that they were going to like feed off each other. And so that was super frustrating that they didn't, because I felt like I would have rather just solely focused on Charlotte's Web and then solely focused on the water cycle. Or just planned it out differently. Trying to do both lessons, like two lessons every school day, was a lot, to where like things like watching Bill Nye, we just were done. We didn't want to do any more school. So I recommend it. I would make sure with any Moving Beyond the Page lesson, you as the parent go through. This is more of like a guide. I do feel like it takes a lot of planning on your part to pick, you know, what activities are you going to do? Are you going to do all the activities they have? Do you need to prepare stuff? Or do you want to find more activities, like the things on Teacher Pay Teachers? So just a little bit more prep work, I think, will make you a little bit more successful in using these. But like I said, they're a great spine to really plan out like a whole lesson. And honestly, we could have made this like a 2-month study on the water cycle if I kind of would have been a little bit more prepared. So I am excited to do future science lessons from Moving Beyond the Page. If you've done one, share your favorite down below. I would love to hear about it. If you guys have questions, comments, leave them down below. Also, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. And if you want more videos on Moving Beyond the Page, make sure you subscribe because I have a lot more coming. Thanks so much, guys. Have a great day. Bye.